Hello and welcome. I'm Monia Gates. I'm the artist behind Color My Dreams. In the description, you will find all the codes of the pencils that I will be using in this stream and the links to my Facebook group. We've got a wonderful goddess event running in Color My Dreams. You're also welcome to join my Patreon platform. The Patreon platform has more in-depth tutorials than in the public stream. And you have access to all the previous tutorials for whatever tier you choose. Hello everybody. Nice to see so many of you here. So tonight I'm coloring a page called Hera. She's part of my Goddess's 2 going to be book as soon as I finish all the pages. So let's start. We've just finished the neck in the Patreon stream, so that is accessible on Patreon platform only. So first I'm going to use a chartreuse, a light layer. So the reason for me using chartreuse as a base color is to brighten up the skin. Because we're going to use lots of browns, you don't want the skin to go muddy or dull. And I find using the green as a base color really helps brightening and keeping the skin color nice and bright. Hi, Caroline. Welcome. Hello to all the patrons. Hi, Iselina. Welcome. Yes, this is not normally the public stream time slot, but welcome. Nice to see so many of you here. Okay, so now we have our base down. Can everybody see okay and hear me okay? The next color is Slate Grey, PC 936. Now I've got a light source coming from my left hand side, so I'm going to have a shadow line on the outside of her face on my right hand side, which I'm darkening at the moment. Abby, welcome. I'm also just going to darken around the hairline because you don't want the face to look like a cutout. You want the face to be shaped and to go slightly darker before you get the hairline. Next color I'm going to use is going to be Dark Umber, PC 947. And I'm using light hand at the moment, light pressure. I'm adding in the shadows that the nose is casting onto the face because of the light source being on my left hand side. And also the lips. Also on the lower lid. Over eye and the upper lid on my right hand side. Hi Sherry, welcome. And the bottom of her lip. Next color I'm going to use is going to be Nectar. Now I'm adding mid-tone shadows to shape the face. You want to show the cheekbones. So now keep in mind the nose is more forward than the cheekbones, for example, and the lips as well. So you need to show the shapes of the face. Just go for it, Iselina. You know, we're adding in the bridge of the nose. The shadow of the upper eye, just above the lid. Oh, thank you, Janine. The mouth corner. A very light hand there. So basically, just shaping the face. Next, I'm going to add in the highlights. I'm going to use Eggshell. Hi, Sonia. Welcome. Nice to see you here. Now, this is to keep a warmth to our shadows. Ach, not to the shadows, to the lights, highlights. And I'm using a light hand so that we can apply lots of layers. I hope you get better soon, Selena. Next is Burnt Ochre, PC 94.3. That is quite an imagination there. I think so too, actually. I can see her doing a ball dance. Venice Walsh. Hello, Karen. Welcome. Now we're just warming up our shadow side. And we're slowly building up the layers. Karen, you are just a master in your work. I love your recent pages. They are gorgeous. Now, when shading the ear, hi Lucia, welcome. You need to just look at the shapes and then just add in your shadows in the areas. So first I'm just going to do the shadows in the shape and then the shape shadows and colors. Then remember to darken the ear here where it's attached to your head so that it looks like it's attached and not a stick-on. Otherwise it will look like it's floating. here by the nose, by the nostril. Again, you need to add in your shadow so that the nose is attached. Now a little bit of shape shadows. This complete nostril I'm pushing back with the in shadow. Add in your shape that the nose will cast onto the face. Oh, don't worry, we'll color here tonight. And if you keep the shapes in mind and where the shadow will fall, then they are not that difficult. But they are normally something that most of the artists and colorists like to skip or to leave out or to cover with hair. Next color I'm going to use is Light Umber, PC 941. And remember when you're coloring the face to use the same colors across the neck, the face and the ears. You can always tone your shadows to the same color and the highlights to the same color when you use the same pencils. So now we first just do a shadow to show that this little section here is on top of this. It's standing up or out from the rest. Then add in a little shape shadow. Then darken here by where the ear hole is. Another shadow to show where the hole is. Because it's the one standing further out, then medium, and then there's a hole inside the ear. In this bottom section, you have a slight protrusion of the section of the ear, and then you get the outside of the ear. So just give it a slight shadow to show that. Then darken your mouth corners. And then just above the lip, a light shadow to show that the skin is bending where the lips are. And those shadows will make the lip stand out and to shape the lip on the face, but still make it part of the face. So it's not like a cutout with a white rim all around. There's shadows around the edges of the lip. Now, give the nose a shape that the shadow is casting onto the other side of the face. And before we carry on, I want to highlight the highlights a little bit more. So I'm going to use powder blue. So powder blue. And put in all your highlights. Hi G. Welcome. And at this stage, oh, hi, Yehan. Welcome. So nice to see you here. And at this stage, you will see that you will start to get more of a 3D effect on the image itself by just adding in your highlights. So this is your shape shadowing done. Oh, it's really nice to see you here, hun. I don't think I pronounced it correctly. So sorry for that. Not sure how to pronounce your name. Now the bottom of the mouth corners, you need to highlight. We've added a shadow at the top to shape the upper lip going folding inward into the mouth corner. Now, because this one is going in and the bottom one is coming out, you need to add your highlight just below the mouth corner. Now also shape the forehead. Oh, that's great. I'm glad I pronounced it correctly. Most of the times I pronounce it wrong. Next is colors Nectar, PC1092. So now we're adding in our pinker tones. Yes, that's true, Sherry. We give all the pencils some love. Here by the ear, add in your pinks. The bottom of the chin. The jawline. Oh, thank you, Yehan. Okay, so basically we are starting to work on the tone of the skin. So it's starting to become a little bit more flesh-like. Now we're going to add in some browns. So first, Burnt Ochre, PC 945. Oopsie. I think let's do a giveaway. Mom and Abby, let's do a number generator. It's not over or under. You can choose a number between 1 and 100. So then you can choose your number between 1 and 100. The winner this week will get, I think, let's do a month subscription to my Patreon with a Patreon exclusive tutorials. I will email you the links. You can may join us for the Patreon streams, and if there's any relevant pages, you will receive the pages. Soften the jawline. So choose your number now. So you can all go now. Choose your numbers. Next, I'm going to use dark purple, PC 931. So, because I've got quite a strong light source, I've got a shadow line on my right-hand side of her face. So now I'm using purple in the shadows to complement the yellows in the skin tone. So playing lightly with complementary colors. We are still going to add browns to the darker tone of the purple, but the play will make it stand out. Yeah, at the top of the ear. Inside of the ear, the dark spot. Here by the bend is also a dark part, because the top part of the ear will cast a shadow onto the middle section here. Hi, Marilee. Then here in the shape, before you get to the inside of the ear, we're just darkening it there. And then a thin shadow on top of the ear that will connect with the dark shadow here. Now, with a very light hand, the bottom of the jaw, Next color I'm going to use is, thank you, Sonia, is Henna. Henna is PC1031. Now just shape your bottom lid. Darken just below the little line on the inside of the eye. And then a thin line, the bottom of the little, what do you call them? Eye bag. What's the corner there of the eye? Soften this shadow line, bring in your shadow a little bit more. Okay, is all the numbers in? So your cheekbones, you shade like this. So this will be darker in the middle here because you need a softened line before you carry on. So if you draw a line like this, you will see a shadow happening to your mouth corners. And some people have it flat down, and some people have higher cheekbones, and that is just this section that will just be smaller or lower. But normally you will get a line going to your mouth corner. Okay, so all the numbers are in. So here is, let's start. And stop. Number 57. 57, Abby and Mom, can you maybe just check and see who's the closest? Next color I'm going to use is Light Umber. Light Umber has that slight green tinge to it. The green tinge. Again, playing lightly with complementary colors. Oh, congratulations, Ry. So if you are a patron, and if you are a patron and you win a patron for a month, then please just DM me or email me or contact me, and then we can discuss other options for you. Yes, Yehan. You can watch it live afterwards. No problem. Hope you have a great day at work. Next, I'm going to use goldenrod. Goldenrod is PC1034. Hi, baby boss, welcome. It was nice to see you too, Yihan. Next is Salmon Pink, PC1001. next. Bye, Karen. You're welcome, Karen. Nice. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it. And thank you, Hyehan. Really appreciate it. Now the top of the ear, need to get a highlight. See, so we're slowly building up the layers here at the moment. Okay, so then it's, let's give it to Marily, which is not a patron, I think. But no problem, it's good if people enter. Next is Pumpkin Orange, PC1032. Then again, the bottom of the shape in the ear, darken the top to show that it's bending, going in there. Slight shadow at the bottom of this shape. Marily, you can just PM me, DM me, or email me. My details are in the description. Then you get a month worth of free patron tutorials. And if there is pages involved, you will get those pages as well. And next is Beige Sienna. Oh, thank you so much for everybody that entered. We'll have another giveaway just now. No, I'm just doing the nose of the bridge of the nose. Darkening the bottom shadow. Getting into the nose. Hi Caroline, thank you for being here. I really appreciate it. Next is Clay Rose, PC1017. And soften the shadow here by the jawline. Back to Beige Sienna. Cover this whole light section here. Next is Nectar again. lighten the middle of the bottom of the eyelid and the corner. Next is Burnt Ochre. Next is Bronze. Bronze is PC 1028. I keep on turning my pencil so that the pencil don't blunt as fast as what you just keep it to one side. So I keep on turning it to keep it relatively sharp. Thank you, Janine. Yes, Sherry, I agree. Definitely. Next is Blush Pink, PC 928. Next is Henna again. So we're slowly building up the layers. And now, is it better? Next is Nectar again. Still blurry. And now I think it could be the quality of the video feed. Was it blurry in the patron stream? Next is Beige Sienna. Okay, that's really strange because it's everything is in the same settings. Let's use light peach now. Anything is possible. We had load shedding, so it could be that everything is taking some time to work properly. Let me just zoom out. Is it better? still with the same pencil. Oh, yes, it does. Load shedding is terrible. Terrible. Next, blush pink. So it's not better. Still the same. This is really funny. Let me see. Yes, it must be the feed then. Next is Clay Rose, PC 1017. But can you all still see what I'm doing? That's the most important part. As long as you can see. Next is Eggshell. No, we've got fiber. But the fiber doesn't work when the power is off and you're load shedding. Then you need to use cell phone towers. And that gets loaded so much with everybody going onto it. So then it goes extremely slow. Blush pink again. Next, Burnt Ochre. In Beige Sienna. Oh my word. What is going on? Then mineral orange. That's the first for me too, Janine. Next, 50% French grey. Next, Nectar. Then Eggshell. You soften the highlight. Oh my word. How do you get rid of this? Then Beige Sienna. I think we can stop here tonight. And then I will do part two, finish up the skin, and then move over to the lips and the mouth for next week. So thank you to each and everyone that came out to the stream tonight. And thank you, Abby and Mom, for being my mods. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you all next week. So then we can carry on with part two of the skin, finishing it off and toning it, and then do the eyes and the mouth. Thank you, Janine. is hopefully we won't have the bot again next week. Bye-bye, everyone. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you next week.